Hello YouTube. Today I show you the soft hackle mayfly in natural color. So I'm using mallard duck feather in natural color. Now tie in the feather. Not too long, because it's not necessary. So bring the thread forward to the eye, the hook. Cut off the waist. So I'm using a very thin silver wire. For the body, I'm using Antron dubbing in gray, this color. Don't put too much on the thread. I'm looking for a smooth and thin body, not a big body. Put too much dubbing on the thread. For this fly, you can also use yellow or olive dubbing, as you want. So, now for the shock, I'm using a red dubbing to give to this fly a little attraction. Now you can make a little shock in front. Also there you can use other colors like mine. So now you can bring up the wire, silver wire. So now we can break off the wire. So nice. Bullets. That's what we need. body. There's a little bit of hairs that stands up. And when the fly is wet, it makes a nice shape. This fly is very good in dry fly, so I can use it as a dry fly and also as a wet fly. I often fish it as a dry fly. It works very well. So, I show you. I use pink and natural gray CDC feather, but only a half piece of feather and cut off. Okay, that's enough. See that? Like this. Now I turn my bobbin. So, okay. Now with my fingers, turn a little bit CDC together and wind it up. From a hand cape, I'm using this color. It's a little bit brown and creamy, cream color. Cut the fluff off and tie in. Now with your hackle plier, grab the feather. Oops. Another try. Turn them a few turns. Front. So now you can cut off the waist. Thread and going back. Goes halfway. So every hackle feather is reared. Let's give this fly a nice shape. So now with my whip finisher, we're gonna finish this fly off. Turns with my whip finisher, and this fly is finally ready to go. Now a drop of varnish. Okay. That's my mayfly. Thanks for watching and see you on my channel. Bye bye.